Welcome everyone. The topic of this video is karyotyping of lesson principles of inheritance and variation. Karyotyping is a technique through which a complete set of chromosomes is separated from a cell and the chromosomes are arranged in pairs. So in a human diploid cell, there are about 23 pairs or 46 number of chromosomes. So out of which 23 number of chromosomes are derived from the father, 23 number of chromosomes are derived from the mother. So the first father chromosome is paired with first mother chromosome. Similarly, the second paternal chromosome is paired with the second maternal chromosome. Likewise, all the 23 pair of chromosomes are arranged in pairs. So that karyotyping is a technique through which a complete set of chromosomes is separated from a cell and they are arranged in pairs. So this technique is also called as ideogram or karyogram, so which refers to a diagrammatic representation of the chromosomes. Preparation of karyotype. Geo and Levin in the year 1960 described a simple method of culturing the lymphocytes from the human blood. Mitosis is induced followed by addition of colchicine to arrest the cell division at the metaphase stage. So by adding colchicine, the chromosomes are arranged or arrested in the equatorial plate, which is also called as the metaphase plate. By this time, the chromosomes are photographed. The individual chromosomes are cut from the photograph and are arranged in an orderly fashion in homologous pairs. So this arrangement is called as karyotype. So the first chromosome of the father is paired with the first chromosome of the mother. So this pair is known as the homologous pair. So likewise, the paternal chromosome number 2 is paired with the maternal chromosome number 2. Such a pair is also called as the homologous pair. So likewise, all the homologous pairs are arranged in a sequential manner. Such a technique is called as the karyotype. Chromosome banding permits structural definitions and differentiation of chromosomes. So there are certain bands located on the chromosomes which are also responsible for differentiation of the chromosomes. The next aspect is about applications of karyotyping, which is very important from 3 marks point of view. So the first and foremost is to identify the gender or to identify the sex of the child. So it helps in gender identification. So it is used to detect the chromosomal aberrations like deletion, duplication, translocation, non-disjunction of the chromosomes. It also helps to identify any abnormalities of chromosomes like aneuploidy. It is also used to predict the evolutionary relationship between the species. Genetic diseases in human being can be detected by this technique. Depending upon the position of the centromere or the kinetochore and the relative length of the two arms of the chromosomes, human chromosomes are of three types, namely metacentric, submetacentric, and acrocentric type. The photograph of chromosomes are arranged in the order of descending lengths in groups from A to G. So thus, the A group consists of first, second, and third pair of homologous chromosomes. The B group consists of fourth and fifth pair of homologous chromosomes. The C group consists of sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, and the X chromosome. This is said to be the largest group. And X chromosome is also included in the C group. The D group consists of 13th, 14th, and 15th pair. The E group consists of 16th, 17th, and 18th pair of homologous chromosomes. The F group consists of 19th and the 20th pair. The G group consists of the 21st and the 22nd pair. And also, this G group includes the presence of the Y chromosome. So with this, the topic karyotyping is getting over. Regarding the next topic, we'll see in the next video. Thank you.